Ooh, I do have one more fisherman's friend here. Can you even hear me over the sound of this bag crinkling?
Yeah. Headphones go in. And hello, everybody. It's the Politicus 5000 back with more Hollow Knight. In the last episode, we made some more progress in our Speedrun 2 attempt, which I reckon is probably going to be successful, considering we're going to get the Monarch Wings at 2 hours. Dude, jeez, I did that on the practice run too. I just barely glided into those. I barely glowed into those. Doom, doom, doot, toot. I have the dung defend music stung in my head, but it's better than alternatives. Doom, doom, doo. Lord knows there ain't. Doom, 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 doo. Any other music to muscle. What the hell just happened? Does anybody else ever get these, like, vision flickers where, like, suddenly you feel like your vision flickers? Oh my god, wow, really? That's where the commentary is gone. It's like sometimes it feels like you blink without moving your eyes. And sometimes it feels like you're reverse blink. It's like the ISO sensitivity on your eye just randomly flashed up or down for an instant. So weird. Oh, you know what? We're not gonna need it. But in case it just happened again. What is that? My eyes are going. I think they might actually be. They're not. Like, I still have fantastic eyesight, but I have noticed recently having a little bit more trouble reading road signs. Oh, that one's easy. Jeez. You can just stand right next to it and swing up at it. Even with the basic weapon, like, no range ups at all, you can do that. You know what I think would be really fun to do sometime would be to do, like, super, super casual video game races of where, like, people play totally different games that have similar run times, you know? Alright. Broken Vessel, and then we'll fight the Lost King, and hopefully that'll give us over 300 essence. Assuming we can beat it in a reasonable amount of time. Which shouldn't be a problem. Although, I don't know. Historically, in the Pantheon of Hallownest, I tended to have a little bit of trouble with... Ow. In the Pantheon of Hallownest, I got my ass kicked by the Lost Kin a few times. Would you stop hitting me so much? I don't appreciate it. Yeah, do that more. Jeez. Holy cow. I tell you what, fragile strength and, you know, making a crazy beeline for pale ores to get nail upgrades is a fantastic way to speed through the game, because you kick all the bosses' asses in like 2 seconds, and most enemies don't survive more than 2 or 3 hits. Alright, here's the Monarch Wings less than 4 minutes into the episode. And that includes all the time it took for us to get here from that bench. I can't believe, oh my god, really? Less than 4 minutes. That's crazy. Now we get to fight that guy again, but he's gonna be exponentially harder, and I'm not looking forward to this because I hate this boss. I would rather fight the failed champion than this bozo. I don't suppose I can... Nope. Ow. Oh, fuck you. Dude, would you suck a dick? Like, seriously. I'm just trying to get into the fight a little bit quicker so that I can waste less time. So that this fight cannot take more time from my life. Yeah, this guy is way faster. But he staggers really quickly. So you get a lot of opportunities to... You get a lot of opportunities to heal, but they're not the most reliable opportunities. This guy's got a long nail. Oh, you know what? I should do there. I should use this. I should use Descending Dark. That's probably a good deal stronger than any other attack I have. Man, I hate when he does that. I hate when he just jumps, because I never see it coming. And it happens so quickly you couldn't possibly react to it in time. Man, fuck you. Ugh. So heinous. Oh my god, we got him. Yes! I hate that boss. Aww. It bothers me that it's... Oh, I think my phone just buzzed. I think I just heard it on the ground. Hey, buddy. How much essence are you worth? 300? 400? 400! Excellent, that's enough to get the pale ore. Alright, that saves a lot of time not having to go out of our way to make a detour to the failed champion. With that, we can now officially avoid going back to the Forgotten Crossroads until we are ready to fight the final boss. But I'm going to come get this grub anyway, even though I have no reason to. Because I'm a good person and I save people in need. Except for all the people I'm forgetting to save because I'm just not going over to them in this run. Like, basically everybody in the Kingdom's Edge. Although nobody really needs help over there. I wonder what Hornet is thinking as all this is happening. I didn't even meet her in the City of Tears. We literally only saw her once in this entire playthrough. That's depressing. What kind of playthrough of Hollow Knight is this where you only get to see your waifu one time? And it's as an enemy. It's a cock-a-tripe is what it is. Okay, so now what are we doing? Well, now that we have the Monarch Wings, I reckon we head up to, you know what? I know exactly what we're gonna do. We're gonna go get Isma's Tear right now. Yes, I think that's a good idea. Is there a fast way I can get up into the Royal Waterways from here? I don't think there is. But we're like right in the neighborhood, so it makes sense to do this now. You know what actually makes more sense and would actually take less time, I think, is to go all the way back down. What the hell, man? You just sniped me from like a mile away, and you sniped me in the future, like 10 seconds in the future. That's crazy. I think it would be faster to actually come down here, go all the way down to the bottom, cross the entire area, spend 300 Geo on the, opening the tram down here, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna travel to the resting grounds, get the next pale ore, then we're gonna travel to Dirtmouth, okay, hang on, I think there's a galaxy brain play here, I don't care. Okay. We're gonna go to... Oh my god, my brain. Where was I going? Hang on. Where was I going? Royal Waterways. Why? Isma's Tear. Right. I'm going to go to Dirtmouth first. because I don't think I can afford both. Right, I was gonna go to the resting grounds. Resting grounds, get the pale ore. Oh, you know what? I can actually do that. I can actually do that. Okay, I'll go to the resting grounds, get the pale ore, cross from there to... Huh?
Oh.
Patamas Gio. Shut up.
Patamas Gio.
800. Good lord. Sure. I don't think we're actually gonna... I don't think we're actually... That was probably a waste of money. I don't think we're actually gonna get enough money to... did I buy Fragile Strength? No, I didn't. Shit. Okay, that's okay. We can pick it up on our way to... Oh, shit, the infected crossroads! Oh, no! Uh-oh, I hope that doesn't mess up my plans here. Here, let me go. I forget what's up here, but I'm pretty sure it's good. So let's go get it. It's a bunch of money. Yes, it is. That's exactly what I needed. And oh no, I'm not dealing with that. I am clear 100% on essence. I don't need any more essence from here to the end of the game. Instead we're gonna sit here for 2 minutes waiting for this guy to throw money at me. Yeah, yeah. Mhm. It drives me nuts that this stuff isn't affected by gathering swarm. Oh, there's another mask shard.
Whee!
Whee!
Thank you for continuing to throw money while I'm sitting here getting a mask. That's Grub Song. That's another badge or another charm to work towards our next charm notch. That's all? Okay, that's a disappointing amount. I really should not have bought that mask shard. But then again, you know, now that I've got that other mask shard, it feels a little more worth it. Oh, you know what else? Here. Ascend. We'll take the, Bye, Tizo. We'll take the tram to the resting grounds. We'll get the reward, because I'm pretty sure she also gives you a Hallow Nest seal at 200. And then we can sell that. We'll go to the city storeroom. Well, wait, have I unlocked? I haven't unlocked King's Station. We'll go straight from resting grounds into the City of Tears, because there's an elevator that goes down right to King's Station. Somewhere around here. You found your way back to me. Was that actually unique dialogue because I didn't talk to her when I first met her? That's funny. Yeah, the Glade of Spirits. I don't care. There we go. Pale ore. We are carrying a pretty penny of treasures, right? That's it? One Hallow Nest seal? That's all? Oh my god. Okay, well, I hope we get some money on the way over there. Oh, you know what? We actually are going to. Because there's that, there's the house on the east side of the City of Tears. There's a house on the east side of the City of Tears. Man, those things are so savage and terrifying when they die. It's terrifying, man. Like the fact that they die like clearly in agony, like, and then they just explode. That's terrifying, man. Okay, and then this goes down to the City of Tears. Now what we're going to do is make our way over, go down to King's Station. We're gonna go down to King's Station. On down to King's Station, gonna have myself a time.
Friendly faces everywhere, humble folks without temptation.
That's a great theme song, I don't care what anybody says. King Station. I don't really need to open up this. Stag station, huh? Not really necessary. They're probably never gonna come back here again. Because I reckon, as long as we are close to Queen's Station, as long as we are close to a stag station, we can take the stag station to Queen's Station to go to Fog Canyon to kill Monomon. Where's the one with the gold? With the guy in gold? Whack that weirdo! Save the guy in blue! God, that is so stupid! Oh, hang on. This isn't the place. Pardon me. Where is that guy? Is he on this level? Is he down here? Did I miss him? No, he's not down here. Where's that guy? The house with the gold dude in it. With the secret gold dude. There's the pleasure house. Is it here? Here it is. Yeah. Ow. Yes, give me your ice cream.
But I got this ice cream as a reward for helping out the community.
It is mine now, biatch. What the? You win this round. You know what I might also do? I might also fight Lurian on the way. I'm pretty sure I can take him. When I did this before, I actually ended up fighting Lurian, or fighting the Watcher Knights, without Fragile Strength. Because, I died to a heavy sentry in his tower. So it should be even easier now. And the Watcher Knights, see, the thing about the Watcher Knights is that, like, if you have a high DPS build, they really aren't that dangerous, as long as you know how to fight them, you know? And the main thing you have to remember for how to fight them is stay up close, and if they go for an attack, jump. Jumping is the best way to avoid the sword swings of the Watcher Knights. 2013. I was in grade. What grade was I in 2013? It was 2015 when I graduated high school. So in 2013... Oh my god, you can't get past these guys, that's right. Shit, this is where I died before. To this exact guy. Okay. That was better, thank god. I mean, anything would have been better than the klutz fest of my first fight with that guy. Oh, you do? Wait, no, you don't. What the heck? How do you open that? Okay. Hang on. I don't know how to advance in this area. Where do I go? Yeah, I should be fine against the Watcher Knights, even without upgrading my shit. Here we go. Oh, you know what? I bet this door only opens if you pull that switch over there. That would make sense. Man, these guys are so chunky. It takes so much effort to lift their fat bods off the ground. They have to go hoi when they jump. And I have no... Also, another thing is that I have absolutely no shame in using the chandelier trick to drop the number of Watcher Knights I have to fight by one. You know? No shame whatsoever in doing that. Not here. I'm gonna fight them now. They're up here. On the other side, there's a vessel fragment protected by a whole bunch of dudes. And I could go... Actually, no, it's that grub. And I don't give a shit about that because it doesn't really matter to me. The thing about vessel fragments is that, you know, upgrading your vessel in this game isn't actually that valuable. Okay, here we go. Watcher Knights. This is a difficult boss fight. A traditionally difficult boss fight. Ow. There's one down. Yeah, see what I mean about... If you have a high DPS, That's the most important thing for this fight. Okay, now get out of the way. Ow. Okay, get out of the way. Shit! Shit, dude. I don't appreciate what you're doing to me right now. Oh my god. Okay. Okay. Whew. Okay. 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 Not a doubt in my mind. Holy shit, that was close. Wow. Could you feel the focus? I feel like the focus there was palpable. God, that scared me. When I fought those guys before on the previous run, on my practice run, I ended up doing it with Soul Catcher and Spell Twister. I think it was Spell Twister. Whichever one is the one that makes your spells cost less, combined with the one that makes hits give you more soul. That was what I used for them. And that worked out pretty well. Alright, there's one down. We might actually be able to get all three of these gone before the end of this video. How crazy would that be if this was a 3-episode speedrun? I mean, it's not really a speed... I don't know. It's the same thing with Tim's old video. His old... Nintendo Capri Sun's old, Link to the Past series, where he hesitates for the entire LP to actually call it a speedrun, because calling it that, you know, comes with certain expectations for how well you play. And he doesn't want to end up shackled to those... Is there really no money reward for beating these guys? Are you kidding me? Oh, here we go. There's also a Hallownest seal here. That's more like it. Okay, 28. Okay, I'm pretty sure that the second and third upgrades to your nail cost 800 and 2,000, so that's actually perfect. It looks like there's more guys there, you know? I can't believe that fight was... Oh my god, that was tense. Whew! I think I aged like 5 years over the course of that fight. Oh, this is actually perfect. Yeah, we can take the shortcut right across to here. Yeah. This is like right next to where what's his face is too. Velmi Artrid. Lembus? Is that his name? Lembus bread? It's like a biscuit! It's like a nice biscuit! What? Oh, that's right. Oh, he's out there right now. That's cool. Man. I knew he did that. I just didn't expect him to do it right this instant. I've never seen that shop closed before, because usually, at this point in the game, if I approach his shop, I approach it by crossing over the fountain, not going up Lurian's tower and then taking the shortcut and then coming back in from the other side. That's ridiculous. Most of the time when I when I come through the City of Tears this way, I pass the fountain on the way, you know? Man, if only I could get all three pale orbs here.
Runjo Stenja.
I would totally do that. Oh, wait. Wait, what? Oh, that's right. I already got the first one. Jeez. You dumbass. You dummy? You dummy! Spiral form. Okay, that's what I ended the last run with. I mean, I didn't even end that run. Like, you'll remember, I stopped before the final boss just to see, like, how much... to see what time I was up to and how much I'd have to improve. Little did I know, I didn't have to improve at all. I was already more than ready. I still can't kill you guys in one hit. That's annoying. Okay, now I'm gonna go down to the Royal Waterways and get Yzma's tier. And then probably go down to the Hidden Station, take it to Queen Station, go kill Monomon, then go down into Deep Nest. Let's see if I remember how to get to Yzma's tier. I mean, I just did it earlier today, so, like, I better. Oh, and when we go, and of course, when we go to Queen Station, and subsequently head over to, when we go to Queen Station, and then subsequently head up through the Fungal Wastes to get to the Fog Canyon, on the side that lets us access Monomon's archives, the teacher's archives. When we are there, the four who are there bring them here. We can stop by Leg Eater and buy Fragile Health, which will come in handy in the final boss fight. And in Deep Nest, actually. I believe at the bottom, in the bottom right corner of this room, ow, we will find a ledge with a crystal on it. Yep, here we are. And this heads into Yzma's Grove through this channel here, and then on the way back, we can cut ourselves off there. We can halt our crystal, our shine spark in the middle of that spiky gauntlet and fall down the middle and quickly drop down to the ancient basin so we can take the hidden station, which will allow us to quickly dash over to the Defender. I wonder what would happen if you somehow managed to come here without fighting the Dung Defender. I wonder if that would even be possible. How did you guys get in here? Oh man, one hit to kill them. That's awesome. Two hits to blow that mother up. You ever feel deja vu? Didn't I say that earlier in this video? I think I did. Oh shit. Don't stun me, you bastard! Fuck you. Wow. Okay, that fight actually gave me some trouble on the previous run, because that was before I fully upgraded my nail. All right, Yzma. I legitimately don't remember where you get the shadow. Oh, you get the shadow dash in the abyss, which requires the going into the Kingdom's Edge to get the king, to get the King's Mark, which lets you get into the abyss, and then you go across the abyss, and that's where you get the Shadow Dash. Because that's the other way that you can get into Monomon's, that you can get to Monomon is by using the Shadow Dash, and the Shadow Dash is definitely more useful than Yzma's tier. I mean, they're both useful, but you know, Yzma's tier doesn't help during Yzma's tier doesn't help in boss fights. Okay, here we go. We're gonna stop halfway through. We're gonna drop all the way down. The fastest direction to travel is down. Because all you gotta do is fall.
It's all yours, Spike. All you have to do is talk.
We might actually legitimately beat the game in this video. I think that's amazing. Because I don't know, man. Like, we only have... Like, all we have to do is, you know, go kill the other two dreamers, and then we're done. I already have everything I need. We're going to... Yeah, Queen Station. We'll go get Hera first. Actually, we should probably get Hera second. Yeah, you know, I'm gonna go get Hera. I'm gonna go get Monomon first. I did Monomon last. Mask shard. Right. There's a mask shard right here. We'll also pick up that one in the Forgotten Crossroads, if I remember. Ow. Oh, all the way back here, man? Come on. That's so unnecessary. There we go. That's three. Oh, we're actually getting... I actually don't need to get the one in the Forgotten Crossroads, because we're going to get one on the way down into Deep Nest. When we take the Fungal Core path down into Deep Nest. Do, 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 do. Do, 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 do. It's interesting that, like, you know, the whole Kingdom of Hallownest is, like, this proud civilization. And, like, with this epic capital city, but, like, right in the middle of everything is the Fungal Wastes, you know? The Fungal Wastes are, like, right at the core of the kingdom. They're right in the middle. I just think that's interesting. Four hits. Jeez. Alright. Stop by Leg Eater. Grab Unbreakable, or grab Fragile Health. Unbreakable, that's a fucking pipe dream in this circumstance. Hey, Leg Eater. Oh, you know what? Here, hang on. You know what? It doesn't matter. I was gonna say, let's put on... Oh my gosh. Holy crap. Ow, ow, there's a welt on my left calf, on the front. Ow! I just scratched my leg, and it just, like, this like, white-hot flare-up of pain shot through my... heart. Jeez, man. How the hell did I not get hit there? Okay, here we go. Into Fog Canyon, to Fogue Canyon. There's a charm notch here, actually, which I would like to get. It's in a really dangerous area, full of violent explosives, but it should be fine. Because I know what I'm doing. Ow! Okay. I can't believe there's no chain reaction there. Ow! Man, I did that perfectly on the last run. There we go. There's a charm notch. That will allow us to. Now we can actually equip both Fragile Strength and Fragile Health, which is obviously valuable. That's all we really need too. I mean, I could probably get away with just Fragile Strength, honestly. Okay, this goes to... It's cool how you have, like, how there are, like, the bodies of those knights here. Yeah, this isn't the place. This is where Cornifer is. Right? Yeah. There's nothing for us here. We want to go down one more. You're supposed to go three doors up from the top. I went two doors down from the bottom. Or whatever he says there. I forget the exact numbers. Because the number is always the least memorable part of the quote. Yeah, here we go. Down here. Just leave them alone. They won't hurt you as long as you don't hurt them. Ow. And here we are. Hey, Quirrell. Bye, Quirrell. Don't mind me. I'm just blasting through. I start blasting! Dang! Okay. Quickly, carefully slide down here. There's a whole lot of crap in the way here. Here we are. This is an annoying fight. Big Umu energy. Alright, Quirrell, wanna come help me out here? Where are you, buddy? I know I haven't talked to you once, so, like, there you go. Shit. Oh, man, that was bunk, man. Kindly use your attack on its body. If you wouldn't mind. Oh, man, if I had gotten one more hit there, I think I would have killed him. I legitimately think that one more hit would have killed it. I don't think I can hit it with that, no. Go ahead. Now? There we go. Oh, okay, no, three more hits. Well, still. Now we can get through here. Open the door. Thank you. Oh my god, I have like nothing to- I'm not saying anything interesting here at all. This is agony. Is it actually po- You know what? You know what? It might not actually be possible to get through here without Yzma's tier. Because you wouldn't be able to navigate this area without it, that's for sure. Because like half the areas in this place don't even have a floor, they just have acid. Alright. Sorry, Monomon, you're a really beautiful lady, but I have to kill you. So that I can accomplish nothing in the history of this place by just taking the place of the... I legitimately wonder, like, what the ramifications of each ending in this game are. Like, I think that the true ending where you just kill the Radiance is definitely the best one, because it completely erases the Radiance and destroys the Knight, and the reason I think that's good is because in the Godmaster ending, the Knight turns into, like, this unstoppable void beast, and that's less than good, you know? Okay, that's two down. Peace out. There's something so cuck-a-feeling inducing about going through this game without talking to anybody, you know? Oh, you know what? I think you'd be able to navigate this area. You just have to use, like, shine sparks. My god, they're being loud up there. It's freaking 12:41 in the morning. Go to bed, you guys. I know, like, you could say the same to me, but, well... Well, yeah, you could say the same to me, couldn't you? And you should, because it's true. Anyway. There we go. I'll tell you another thing. I forget if I mentioned this in the first episode, but doing this, I think, is going to be great for me when it comes to possibly eventually attempting to do the Pantheons with more bindings. You know, getting used to fighting bosses with less is obviously a valuable thing.
I don't have a map for this area. I have no fucking idea where I am.
I don't think I can cross over to the side that hooks up to Queen's Station without the Shadow Dash. Actually, I might be able to. Ow. Okay. Excuse me. There might, this might be like a one-way path if you do it like, jeez. I might be able to go, oh, wait, Cornifer's still here? What are you doing here? Okay. How did, why are you still here? if it's not killing Monomon that makes you go, that makes you leave this area and put them, and puts the map for this area in the shop, then what could it possibly be? Man, if this does turn out to be the finale, this is gonna be some lackadaisical ass finale. I mean, seriously, I'm just like, just like quietly playing, humming choral tunes. Oh man, here we are back in the Forgotten, in the Infected Crossroads. That's crazy. Now, I want to take the path down to... Where am I? I have no fucking idea where I am. Right now, I am... I think I'm there. Hey, a friend! Where am I? Oh, you know what? I think I have to keep going right here. That makes sense spatially, so I guess that's to be figured. I'm surprised that all the stuff in here doesn't explode. I mean, it does, like the enemies do, but like none of the environmental things explode. You'd think the environmental explosives would get worse. Here we go. I want to go back down to the fungal waste so I can go through the fungal core to get into Deep Nest. Because that will give me another mask shard to complete another mask. Pardon? Okay, now we're gonna go down. We wanna go down. We actually wanna head for the Mantis Village right now. And if I accidentally go the wrong way and end up going to a... If I accidentally go the wrong way and end up missing the mask shard here, then that's fine. We can just pick up the one in the Infected Crossroads on the way up to the Black Egg, to the Black Egg Temple, so that's fine. But it looks like it's not going to be a problem because we can just pass through here. Okay, so it's right here. This is the... Wait, no, it's not. It's right here. The room that stumped me for so long on my first playthrough because it took me forever to get the Monarch wings. We can just cross down here through the fungal core. Man, one of you guys all the way down here? That's a new one. And this will eventually drop us into Deep Nest right on top of a mask shard. Ow. One hit. Oh, and somewhere around here is the mushroom... thing that, like, has all the answers. Oh, I guess I missed it. I think it was in the first room. Oh, well. Nope, maybe I... Oh, no. It'd be right here. Ow. It's right over here. Yeah, here you go.
Pale worm, what good to foresee a demise unavoidable? I don't know. It's one of life's great mysteries.
Here we go. Deep Nest, Mask Shard. Huzzah! I would like to find a bench, and put on unbreakable health, because we don't need money anymore. So I can afford to abandon. And we're not going to die down here, I don't think. We shouldn't. Unless I get into a particularly nasty altercation with one of those devout stalkers, which would be bad. But even that would be, you know, we could recover from that. I think I missed Cornifer. I wanted to buy his map. Yeah, this doesn't look familiar. I think I'm in the wrong place. I don't think I'm heading towards the hot spring right now. Well, maybe actually. I don't know. Hard to tell with Deep Nest. Oh, I'm at full HP. I thought for sure I'd taken a hit somewhere. And then I looked at my HP and I was full. Nope, nothing that way. Over here? Oh my god, I have no fucking idea where I am right now. Mom, come pick me up, I'm scared. Okay, we are in the right place. I don't know how I wound up in the right place, but we are going the right direction. That's not it, that's the pit I died in on my first, in the LP. And here we are, here's the bench. We're gonna take off Gathering Form, we're gonna put on Fragile Heart. And that's probably gonna be how our charms stay for the entire rest of the game. Now I hope I don't become complacent with this newfound amount of HP, but I shouldn't. I'm pretty good at this game. In case you hadn't noticed. So now we're just heading left. Just whatever you do, keep going left. It shouldn't be too big of an issue. Bye. He didn't even care. It's like, whatever. Like, alright, I guess. He knows what he's doing. I don't love that. I don't love you. You guys still take multiple hits. That's scary. Wasn't there an up here? There was. Is this a way I can get through here without running into any devout stalkers? Or stalking devouts? I can never remember if their name is Devout Stalker or Stalking Devout. I literally never can. And there's a grub here. I wonder if it's an imposter. I don't think it's an imposter. I think the grub imposters only appear in like two places in the entire game. And this isn't one of them. There's one in Crystal Peak. There's one room full of them somewhere in here. And then there's, are we here already? Ow. I think we're here already. 48 minutes. There's definitely not going to be enough content left. This is the finale. There's not going to be enough content left in the game for another episode. so even if this goes over time a bit, we have to end it here. Hey guys. With this so happy music. I should look up a loop of that music on YouTube, ambient noise, because I think it actually sounds... I think the dissonance only sets in after you sit down? Don't quote me on that. This area, I hate this area. The Beast's Den, because I always get lost in here because it's not on the map. There's no map for this area. Ever. You never get a map for this area, and it is so aggravating. No. Oh man, 4 hits is all it takes to kill you guys. That's pathetic, man. Finding Hera isn't even the problem here. It's finding the way out. That's the hard part. The hard part. Something about that is so stupid. The hard part. What was that? Something's heart is beating up here, and it's scary. Ow. Excuse me. Hey. Okay, that's where. Oh my god, I am not saying anything. I'm so sorry. I just totally ran out of commentary. I shouldn't have recorded this tonight. Ow. Man. That was almost awesome. It's amazing, you know, when you buff your nail up this much, it's amazing how wimpy the vengeful spirit becomes. Especially if you don't bother to upgrade it, which I haven't, obviously. Hey, Hera. Sorry about your... Sorry I didn't listen to your daughter. Or really ever see her again, except for that one time. Well, I guess she led me into the City of Tears. That was the last time we saw her. There's something scary about that, you know? There you go, that's 3 of them. That's all 3. Now, literally, all we have to do is get out of here and go take the stag stagway up to the infected crossroads and go kill the Hollow Knight. Like, wow. I did a lot more messing around on my last run. This has gone a lot smoother. And it's amazing how quickly it's gone by. Like, I can't believe it. This is crazy. Now, if I can, now, here's the question. Can I find my way out of this place in a reasonable amount of time, or are we going to spend, like, 5 minutes trying to figure out where the fuck to go? Because I honestly don't know. Like, I don't know where the exit is. Like, this is the entrance. It's not here. It's not here. This is where we first showed up. So that's not there. Oh my god, here we go. It's not there. I think that's just it's not a dead end, but it's not anything important. Yeah, that's just the other side of this passage. It's not there. I'm pretty sure it's on the left somewhere. It's not here. That's a dead end with a statue in it. And here we are back up where Hera was. That's not it.
How do you get out of here, man? I feel so stupid.
Like, I literally don't know where to go. Would you get out of the fucking way? Jeez. Oh, here we go. You just drop down there. Yeah, okay. And then here's an actual bench for you to sit on. And there you go.
Let's get out of here.
Now, the million-dollar question is... Can we beat the Hollow Knight before we cross the hour mark? So unnecessary. I'm just flexing at this point, like, seriously. Hey, man. Take me to the Forgotten Crossroads. It's time to end this once and for all while my family laughs obnoxiously loudly upstairs at whatever the fuck show they're watching. 1 o'clock in the morning. I mean, to be fair, it is Friday. Mom does not work tomorrow, so... Get out of here. How annoying. You're annoying. Dang me. Ha 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 ha. Well, see ya. Here, buy yourself a juice or something. Cha-ching. I shouldn't be spending my... I would like to save my soul so I can bring it into the fight with me. I think we're gonna be fine. Call me crazy, but I'm pretty sure we're gonna be fine. I mean, the Hollow Knight is not the hardest boss we've fought today. That honor would probably go to either Lost Kin or the Watcher Knights. Both of them were very close fights. That cannot be overstated. Ow. Not gonna bother healing, because I'm gonna heal at the bench in the Black Egg Temple. Yes, I am. Alright. It's amazing how huge this world is, and how quickly you can traverse it. Like, seriously? Didn't I leave the Beast's Den at, like, 54 minutes and 30 seconds or something? And now I'm standing in front of the final boss door, like, less than 2 minutes later. Our completion percentage is in the pits, but that doesn't matter. I don't care. No, actually, I am curious. Hollow Knight's Behold again. Completion percentage viewable in inventory. 40%. 40% in less than 3 hours. Now that is impressive. I mean, well, I don't know. 2 hours and 50 minutes. That's almost a full hour faster than my last run. Than the practice run. That's crazy. Did I really spend that much time talking about Avril Lavigne? Alright, bro. I'll make this quick. Do the sounds. Hey, quick win! I can't believe I got two heals off there. That was crazy. Oh man, is he here already? Oh my god. Well, it's a good opportunity to heal, I guess. Don't worry, dude, it's almost over. Oh my god, man, he really wants to die quick, huh? Oh my god, he's going crazy. I will take the infection into myself, brother! Hoo-ah! Oh my god, I don't believe it. We actually did beat him before the hour mark. Holy shit. Wow. I never thought I'd see this day. Now I just gotta do it on Steel Soul. Well, you know, I never died, so... You know, there is that. I love how when it closes, you hear the sound. It almost plays the sound that it makes when you get an upgrade, where it goes like, bum, bum, bum. It almost plays that sound. Oh my gosh, the credits started like right on the hour mark. That's incredible. Well, this has been a super fun experience. I mean, I recorded this all in one day. I've got so much stuff recorded in backlog that like I don't know what that like I need to finish. I need to start uploading. I still have Terraria videos to upload. I recorded Drunk Luigi's Mansion. Well, like Tipsy Luigi's Mansion. Not really drunk. Just tipsy and kind of playing it up. The first one was legitimately like, I am inebriated, but the second two were kind of forced. I have that Diddy's Conquest video I want to put up. But we're not talking about that. We're talking about Hollow Knight. Of course, what is there to talk about? You just beat the game in less than 3 hours. You know? That was awesome. I can't believe how close that fight with the Watcher Knights was. Hoo-wee. I look forward to seeing, like... I can't wait to see the achievement pop up on the screen. It's gonna feel so good. 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 It's what's especially crazy is that, like, I remember plotting out, like, thinking, okay, in order to beat the game in less than 5 hours, I have to do this. If I want to beat the Watcher Knights in less than 5 hours, I gotta do this. I gotta get Paylors. I gotta pick what Paylors I'm gonna get. I gotta do it, and I gotta route it all. And then, like, in the last 3 days... I picked the game up after not having played it for, like, 6 months, almost a year. Like, it's September 26th. It's almost been a year since the Hollow Knight LP started. I just picked it up today, or, like, 3 days ago, started playing, made it to the end of the game in less than 4 hours, and then today, picked it back up and beat the game in less than 3 hours. I can't believe that happened. Man, only 2,100 backers? That seems like not a lot. How much money did this game make on Kickstarter? You persevered and you triumphed. We hope you enjoyed yourself in the world of Hollow Knight. I sure enough did. This is some. I knew it was going to be fun to do Speedrun 2 attempts, but I didn't expect it to be that fun. Give me the achievement, man. Speedrun 1 and Speedrun 2. Game completion. Percentage 40 is not that great. Time 22 hours and 53 minutes. Holy shit, I wonder when it actually counts, when it stops counting. Is it when you land the final hit on the Hollow Knight and the death animation starts? Or is it when, like, when you're sucking in all the infection and it cuts to black at the end of it? Because that would be where I would cut it. Holy crap, less than 3 hours. That is unreal, man. I wonder if I get, like, a... It'd be cool if you got, like, an... It would be cool if you got another menu style for that. I like Void. It's just really... It's a bit too dead. I don't know. What's the coziest one? Honestly, probably Classic. Let's just go with Classic. So, I hope you enjoyed these Hollow Knight bonus episodes. Next time, if there is a next time, probably what I'll try to do is I will try to go through Steel Soul mode. I don't know if I'll go for 100% right away or not, because Steel Heart obviously requires you to get 100%. Not 107, not 100%, not completion, just 100%. Which is important to note. There's leeway there. There's 12% of leeway. Which I am very fascinated about. But Steel Heart, I think, is definitely going to be one of the last things that I'm confident enough to do. Because it's just like, holy crap. I mean, get 100% without dying once. I mean, I only died... Like, before starting the Godmaster stuff, I only died single-digit times in the base LP of, like, the whole game. But, like...
beating the whole game without dying once and getting 100% just seems terrifying. But anyway, I've held you here for long enough. I hope you all enjoyed watching these speedrun videos. I think I already said that, but I'm so bad at remembering what I have and haven't said, and I should stop saying that I'm so bad at XYXYXY because that's not helping anything. I need to get better at... No, that's bad too. I don't know. I'm gonna go to bed because it's 1 o'clock in the morning and I shouldn't be up this late. I think G went to bed already. She got the mattress today and she was all tuckered out from carrying it, and it was really cute because she was all tired in Discord. Anyway. Bye!